Hey everyone, it's Erin, EW Wellness Solutions, and today we're talking about not comparing ourselves to others. It's a doozy, right? I brought in Journey to help. So, how to start? It's a real big task, right? Social media does not help. Ever had one of those days where like everything's going wrong? And you just, you know, pick up your phone, you're cruising through Instagram, and you look at someone's feed, pick a person, any person, someone you kind of like, someone you don't like at all, whatever. And you're like, how come they're always having fun? And I'm standing here at Walgreens waiting for my kid's ear infection medicine. What the heck? Well, they're not showing their picture of waiting at Walgreens for their ear infection medicine, are they? They're showing a picture of their vacation. That's good stuff, right? If we all showed pictures of waiting in line at Walgreens, that would be all we'd see on Instagram. Everyone's showing their highlight reel, the best of. I call it the Christmas card pictures. Who sends out Christmas card pictures where they look bad? No one, really, right? It's usually a good picture. Everyone looks so happy. Look at us, we wear matching outfits all the time. Isn't it amazing? We're standing on the beach at dusk, yay us. When you know the backstory, you know that so-and-so is having a problem with this, blah, 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 blah. Everyone's like that, right? Everyone has a real life. Everyone has real life stuff. But yet our Christmas card pictures, I mean, holy moly. Look at how happy we are. We are so happy. And we wear matching clothes that are color coordinated. Right? If you just looked at everyone's Christmas card picture and you thought that was an accurate assessment of our everyday lives, you'd be completely wrong. Down to our clothes. So when we look at that kind of thing, it's impossible to not be like, wait, how come my kid's birthday cake isn't as great as the one on Pinterest? Because nobody really puts up their fails, right? You only put up the successes, not the 10 cakes that looked weird. You put up the one that turned out beautifully. So when we compare ourselves to other people, whether it be how your shamrock cake didn't rise or whatever, or why is everyone having fun but me? Stop it. Stop. It's not real. First of all, what you think you're comparing yourself to is not real. Second of all, you're really denigrating your own self because you should be focusing on what is working, right? What is going well, not what isn't. Because we're always doing better than we think we are. We have this sort of negative inner child voice thing that happens to a lot of us of, we should be here in our careers. We should be more this, we should be less that. Why doesn't our hair have more natural bounce? You know, why isn't our skin perkier? Whatever, whatever, right? Because we see these models or we see this person or we see whatever, we're comparing, comparing, comparing. That's all that is, right? So when we're continually in a state of comparing, we're pretty much making ourselves forever sentenced to a life of despair in a lot of ways. I remember a long time ago, there was an interview with Cindy Crawford, and she said, even I don't wake up looking like Cindy Crawford. Meaning, she doesn't wake up looking glamorous. She probably wakes up looking pretty stinking good, but with the hair and the lighting, that's not how she looks in the morning. She probably has a little, you know, maybe a little wrinkly from the pillow stuff going on. But when you see the smoking hot model in the Pepsi ad, realize that took a team of people. And that's okay. She's still a rockin' hot lady. But don't be upset because when you wake up in the morning, you know, you look a little funky. When we think of self-love, one of the best places to start is what we do have, what we do like about ourselves. And it can be really hard if we are continually looking for the approval of others. And when we talk about our careers or our businesses, I've noticed, because I'm starting a business, I've started a business, I have a book, I'm in this entrepreneur world, there's a lot of people who think so-and-so is doing really well, or did you hear that so-and-so da-da-da-da? And I'm always like, how do you know that? How do you know that? Because they said so? Like, you don't know anything. Just keep doing what you need to do for yourself. Because who cares? Who cares what they're doing? You know, if they're succeeding, that's great. More power to them. It shouldn't really impact what you're doing, right? There's always going to be weight loss books, right? There's always going to be people who are talking about overeating. But it's just, I mean, since probably forever, there were, you know, they used to call it reducing. So if I sat up at night thinking of all the blogs that were being written and all of the Instagram people that were doing wellness things, I wouldn't get any sleep, right? So all I can do is what I can do. That's it. It's all I can really do. Because if I'm obsessed with what this person is doing, what that person is doing, I don't have any time left to improve my own business, to write my own content, to make videos for you, to work with my own clients. It's a huge distraction. And also, you really have no idea what the other person is truly doing. And for all you know, maybe you could collaborate with them, quite frankly. There's a woman I met at a conference a couple weeks ago. She's this great low-carb blogger, Low Carb Yum. She wrote a review of my book on her website. It was amazing. You guys should totally go to her website if you ever need any low-carb recipes. I met her. I had no idea who she was. We were just chit-chatting at this mixer. She's got an amazing following. I had no idea. I just thought she was someone nice at a party. If I knew who she was, would I have still talked to her? Probably. But it's still a person. So if we're always worried what other people are doing, we're never going to get out of bed. So stop comparing. Just go live, right? Happy Sunday. Bye.